motherfucker won't crash my goddamn drone, cause that shit was expensive.
It's a nice shot.
It's a nice shot. Yeah. Okay. Snake, good. I try to tell him both. I try to tell him both. Let's get it. I got you on what? Yes. One time, one time, one time.
Welcome back to the Sweater Guys web series. For this this episode, we want to catch you up on what we've been working on, and that is a totally new website experience. If you are allergic to seeing things like this, then you should probably just turn off now. Without further ado, here is the story of the Sweater Guys website.
Chapter 1, The Sweater Guys as a tech company.
In the early days of The Sweater Guys, we realized pretty much off the bat that we would need a website. And the best way to do that at the time was by building a Squarespace website.
This episode was brought to you by Squarespace.
Brought to you by Squarespace.
Squarespace, 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 Squarespace.
This episode is not sponsored by Squarespace. Squarespace is a pretty fast way of building non-functional static websites.
Boom. Roasted.
When a client reached out to us and they said, we want 20 sweaters by next Friday, we'd have to say, okay, send us your design. And then we'd have to say, okay, where do you want the design on the hoodie?
We would go into Photoshop and create a mock-up with their logo, send it to them, but they'd want it a bit more into the center and a bit down. They want the image larger, additional text on the sleeve, create the mock-up, center and a bit down, larger, the sleeve down, center down, larger, Photoshop, mock-up.
So that's when we realized we would need a design studio.
Chapter 2, fashion is never finished.
We settled on WordPress.
We did some research and found that WordPress would basically enable us to have a design studio without us having to code it.
It allowed you to render images and then users could move designs around on those images. WordPress became way too bloated. It just became a nightmare. All right, let's talk about Express. We learned how to code and built our own website from scratch. The website was built in the framework Express, which is a really fast way of building functional APIs or websites. So we want to have a design studio, we want to have a front page, we want to have a cart, and we want to have a checkout. Jim logs onto the website and wants to see Jim's cart, whereas Dave logs onto the website and wants to see Dave's cart. And you don't want Jim to be able to see Dave's cart, and you don't want Dave to be able to see Jim's cart. So we built accounts, which requires an authorization router for sign in, sign up, and viewing your account data. Now you were able to enter your email, enter your password, and create an account on thesweaterguys.com. We were able to attach design information, upload information, and card information into your account. To this day, that's still the website that we use. The truth about our Express website is that it was built with one function in mind, and that was checking out designs. So we were at a place where users were requesting features every day as our platform was scaling, and we weren't able to implement those features fast enough. We wanted to build a fully autonomous process, but in order to do a fully autonomous process, we need to start deconstructing how a sweater is made. And that's when we had the important realization that there is so much data required to do what we are trying to do. Chapter 3, the new thesweaterguys.com. What we're working on this summer is a complete redesign of our website. And I know you've heard this before.
Built a website which really took off.
I introduce the new website. Basically, we've been trying to take the website that we built, but there's a reason why we're doing this. There's a very new and exciting API language called GraphQL. What GraphQL allows you to do is it allows you to nest and link data in the form of a graph, basically. Our project for the summer is partitioned into a front end and a back end. The back end handles all of the logic behind data storage and APIs, and the front end is basically what you see. Our back end uses Postgres SQL, Prisma 2, and Apollo Server. Our front end uses Apollo Client, React, and Redux. So stay tuned. We are going to be announcing a beta of this project at some point over the summer, so we'll make another video when we do that. And we'd love for any of you who are interested to sign on to that beta, test the website out, and give us feedback. My initial perspective coming from a design background was that coding is like nerdy and math-based. But now I realize that the opposite couldn't be more true. So for any of you out there watching this video and saying, wow, this is sick, I want to start my own website, my honest advice advice is just do it.
Do it.
The process is incredibly simple. You outline what you want to do, and then outline all of the questions you need to answer in order to do it, and then just Google those questions and follow the steps that it returns. And that's how you learn the fastest.
Next week on The Sweater Guys.
Hey Dex, what are we doing?
God!
I have the footage for this week on The Sweater Guys.
Get it over to Ben, we'll put it on TikTok.
I don't know where Ben is.
He's home.
Yeah. 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 I should make him say, oh!